Honorable Prime Minister, members of the board, Imran Khan, thank you very much, and the friends, thank you very much. As I said before, I am honored and I thank Allah for giving me this opportunity to design this campus. So I'm just going to go briefly over what is where, so can I explain you the thought behind. So
basically, we have this hill in the middle of this whole thing, and we have a campus on one of the north side and one on the south side. And when we started designing this thing, we do have existing building, which is here. And this is the residency building, and this is another. This is the building we're in right now, and there's going to be a different stadium. So we have all this land, and we did a lot of thinking, and we said, well, how are we going to create this campus based on projects to this vision? So I always believe that as an architect, we're like chefs. We're not really, somebody has to order. So it's his vision and the Lima Khan's vision and the board's vision that they brought me in and they asked me to put it together. And fortunately for me and for this Namal Education Foundation, I have spent 30 years of my life, most of my projects have been in hills. And a lot of architects, very difficult to design in contours. For me, it comes naturally. So when I looked at this thing, I saw obviously there are two distinct areas in this property that we could use. And then there was a thought of, should we design a campus which is mixed, like NYU, where you have one building that's an academic building, next building is the housing building. I decided to go against it, and the reason I did that is because I said when people come here, and they actually are living here, I want them to go away from academic block because there's no other city where they can go. So they should have a little bit of separation. So I thought this would be perfect. If I could put all the academic block on this side and then create a beautiful drive or a walk, and that walk, by the way, is 15 minutes walk as you have seen it, and the drive is like less than 10 minutes drive, and then develop all the housing in this area. And when we were there earlier, we were actually, this is the piazza, and we were sitting right here, there was a tent, and this is where we were. And this piazza becomes the center, like I said before, it becomes the center of this entire project. It's like a heart, a node, a piazza, a public square, where you have all your housing for professors. They're going to be living on this hill. And by the way, they do get views of the lake through this canyon. And all the students are going to be living in these buildings. And then this central is going to be a central commercial building where they have shopping, they have cinemas, and they go for a stroll over here, and then it becomes a natural park kind of an environment over there. And then in this area, we decided to put an Olympic-style recreational facility for gyms and indoor pools, and there will be a soccer field over here. And then when you go around over there, this would be all our academic buildings. And we designed it based on US campuses where they have courts in between buildings and there's a lot of students walking. You're taking class at this building, you're taking class at this building, you're crisscrossing. So we have these courts that are lined up, so all the buildings are around the courts. And there's, of course, a roar that goes on all the sides. So this was basically the concept. And we tried to keep the buildings not more than 4-story high, so we don't have to put in the elevators. This is the view from the other side. This is where the piazza is. And I truly believe that piazza is going to be the center point. And these buildings will accommodate 400 to 500 students. So if you count these buildings, we should be able to house 5,000 students here. They will be living here. But overall, in this entire thing, we should be able to, when it's complete, inshallah, be a university for 10,000 students. This is the master plan of the whole thing, and here's where the big hill is. And we come down here, these are the existing buildings, and this is the building we're in. And then it goes all the academic block, connects it to bridges and the waterways, and then that's your shopping piazza, and this is, that's the professor. And we're also going to provide a hotel. One of the beauty about this thing is I noticed that they have hot springs. I don't know if people went down there and saw those hot springs. but the hot springs are at the foothill of the mountain on the other side of that thing. So we decided that we're going to build a hotel on the top of the mountain, and we're going to do a cable car going down, and we can build wellness centers down there, which can also be used to provide income for the complex of the university. So next. These are the North Campus and the South Campus. Here's some images, inspiring images from other universities. As you can see, the courts from different universities, which are like courtyards in between these buildings, and it becomes the focal point. That's where kids take pictures, and they're walking with their bags between buildings. This another North Campus, another North and South Campus. Go next. Now, this is our phase one plan. This is what we're working on right now. We are designing the infrastructure of this entire complex because we want to design the whole infrastructure one time. So we don't have to do what happens usually in countries like Pakistan and others, where they build inadequate infrastructure, then they add more stuff on it, then they dig it in the middle, cut the road, put another pipe, then 2 years later cut the road again, put another pipe. We don't want to do it because you end up paying a lot more money that way than doing it all upfront one time. So infrastructure will be done. But if you see this here, we want to build this piazza, and we want to build 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 buildings. We want to build these buildings as boys and girls hostels. And we all the red line, that's the road that we want to build. All the yellow is the area that buildings that we're going to build. We're going to do some townhouses for the professors, and there's also going to be 40 apartments on top of this, which is going to be also used by the professors. We are going to add some academic buildings and create these few courts. That's our initial goal. And here's some views from a different angle. This is the student housing. That's the piazza. We were, by the way, the tent was here. We were looking this way, and then that equipment was over here, and that's what we did the groundbreaking. This is the view of the piazza at night. You have this beautiful sunset that happens here. These are going to be the student housing overlooking the piazza, and then of course there will be some apartments on top of those buildings. This is a typical block. Now I want to warn everybody, this is not necessarily the architecture of the buildings. This is because it's part of master planning. We are doing a form and a shape what the building will look like, but necessarily when we design the buildings, it will take a different shape, but they will be located exactly there. It won't be located here. We will have quads, like I said before. This is a picture of a quad, a rendition of a quad. So we do have an animation that we have done, and we'd like to show that animation if we can.
That I am really honored to be working on this university. I was barely 19 years old when I went to America, and it was an eye-opener for me. I come from here, I go to America, you start noticing things like switches are upside down, but you notice how they have really mastered their cities, their schools. I went to university there, in New York University, and beautiful university, and you always think, why can't we do this in our own country for our own people? So, but then, you know, as you grow, you go after the money, you want to build a big house, you want to drive Bentleys, and you just get into that rat race. And I was telling these friends last time when you were not here, I'm 57 years old, and when this opportunity came, my kids are grown up, my daughter is going to be grandfather next month. So I was telling my wife, I said, we don't need money now. I said, I want to know, how can I do something? And then this opportunity showed up. And I truly believe that this is a divine intervention, that I am here. And I am doing this, I promise, I want to assure you, not a single penny am I making from this project, personally. And I want my very good friend who introduced us many, many years ago when he came to our house and we raised funds over there in Los Angeles. I want to acknowledge that. Thank you very much.